Good morning, children. Today we are going to see physics chapter 14, electricity. So in the last class we discussed about fuse and how come the fuse is overcome, when does it happen, why does it happen? It's because of short circuiting and overloading of current, right? So today we are moving to the next, that is the heating effect of electric current. So what does the heading tells us? Heating effect of electric current. It means when an electricity is passed, heat is produced. How come heat is produced by passing electricity? Is it beneficial to the human beings? Okay, let us see that today. First, let tell me what is an electricity. When you have a connecting wire, if the charges are flowing from the positive to the negative terminal, the flow of electricity is detected, right? So during this passage of electricity, heat is produced. The heat produced is used as beneficial one by the human beings as room heaters, iron box and water heater. These appliances require electricity for their operation. When I put the switch on, only the iron box will iron the dresses, right? So what is present inside these appliances so that it produces heat while passing electricity? They have an important one inside their structure, that is the element. The element present inside these appliances is responsible for the heat produced. So tell me, what is meant by an element? An element is a coil of wire. Okay, this word element has many meanings. In chemistry, you would require it, you would represent it as a group of atoms. But in physics, it is a group of wires. You know that the wires are an essential component of the electric circuit. These wires are made up of different materials, as we know. It may be made up of copper, or it can be even made up of silver. We know that the silver is the best conductor, but since they are expensive, we prefer copper wires, right? We have learned that in the lower grades itself. So this wire, which is a good conductor, will allow the passage of electricity when it is all grouped together. When it is grouped together as a coil. Coil means a bunch or a group or a numerous amount, okay, of wires are grouped. It behaves like an element. This element, which is present in the appliances, is responsible for the heat produced. Now open your textbook and in chapter 14 you have the images of the element present inside the iron box. You can even refer it in the nearby shops. If you have any repairing mechanic shops and all, there if you ask them regarding the iron box or the room heater elements, they would show you. Okay, they are just like your steel rods or some kind of iron rods only they look, but inside them you have the coil of wires. Okay, maybe in this shape you would have the coil of wires inside them, which is responsible for producing the heating effect. Okay, so I repeat again, for the heating effect of electricity, whenever you pass electricity, how is the heat produced is by the presence of element. So human beings have made this concept of electricity as a beneficial one to them. Okay, that led to the invention of room heaters, iron box and water heaters too. Okay, just by passing electricity we obtain heat. Okay, the next thing is the amount of heat produced by this element depends on various factors. I must know that how much amount of heat is produced on passing the electricity, right? Based on the amount only, I can calculate them and I can choose the perfect location for using these appliances. If an iron box, okay, what is the amount of electricity consumed by it and what is the amount of heat produced? For a water heater, it varies, whereas for a room heater, it varies. The heat produced does not remain the same in all the three cases. It is going to be a varied one. Okay, so on which factor I am classifying them? Should I measure them on based on what factors? The three important factors on which they depend are material, thickness and length. Okay, so for 7th standard, you just get to know about on what factors does the amount of heat depends. Once you go to 9th standard, a very detailed explanation of these factors are given. You would learn that in your higher grades. It is beautifully explained there. Okay, so I will just give you a gist now. So the heat produced depends on the type of material. Okay, so we know that the fuse wire is made up of tin and lead. That is what we tell it as. Some materials are made up of nichrome too. We know that all the objects are not conductors. Some materials are good conductors and some are poor conductors. But when you consider the good conductors alone, again there occurs a classification, which is the highest one of conducting, which is the least element or material of conducting. Yes, do you have the variations? Like copper is a good conductor, but compared to the copper, silver is the best one, right? And nichrome is also a conducting material only, but compared to copper and silver, it is somewhat lesser one. So depending on the material, the heat is produced. The next one is the thickness of the material. Thickness in the sense, I told you, coil of wires is a group. So on how much wires you are going to group. So the thickness and the length. Okay, so consider a circuit having so many components and a lengthy wire, and then a circuit with the connecting wire shorter in length. Okay, so let me explain it like this. This is a circuit, okay, and you have the bulb here. If the wire is the shortest one, what happens to the electric flow? Whereas if you draw this as a very bigger one, so long wires you are using and such a way it travels for 1 meter and then reaches to the bulb. Will the current flow is efficient in case B or in case A? Case A, you have the wires of shorter length, okay, near to the circuit itself. I mean, all the components are nearly connected. Whereas in case B, the components are connected at a long distances. So in which case the electric flow would be efficient one? It is obviously in the option A, right? So the length of the wire is also a matter. It also matters to us. Based on that, the heat is produced. Right, so that is why we have our switchboard in your room. Consider you have the fan here and the switches in the same room. You doesn't have it in the next house for the switches. So then and there we fit it, right? So the length of the wire is also a matter. We are now moving to the next effect of electric current, that is the magnetic effect of electric current. So what is this? On passing electricity, magnetism is observed. How is it possible? Why, we are just passing the electricity, but how come the magnetic effect is noticed? Let us see now. This phenomena of magnetism observed during electric flow was found out by Hans Christian Oersted. He is a scientist who found out the magnetic effect of electric current. Hans Christian Oersted. Okay, so let us consider this as a simple electric circuit connecting your battery, key and the bulb. So from the positive terminal, the current starts to flow, and since the switch is in the off position, it will not glow. Once the switch is in on position, the electric current flows and the bulb glows, right? So when the electricity is flowing, what do you want to do is, if you just keep a magnetic compass near to the electric circuit, means the compass needle gets deflected. Usually what is the role of a magnetic compass? We have learnt in the grade 6 itself. Magnetic compass will help us to find the north, south, east, west directions, because they have the needles of the compass have the magnets. the magnet will always point towards the north and south. Each magnet will have two poles, north pole and south pole, right? That is the speciality of a compass. So this compass having magnetic needle gets deflected while placing near to a circuit on passing electricity. How come it is possible? Does this mean whether on passing electricity the circuit also has the magnetic effect? Yes, you are right. On passing electricity, the circuit has the magnetic effect also. That is the reason why the magnetic compass gets deflected. So like this is a bar magnet. It has two poles, north and south. So each magnet will develop a kind of magnetic field around it. So that is the reason why it attracts any other magnetic material nearby to it. So these lines which I have drawn now indicates the magnetic field, north to south, that kind of. So yes, these lines are nothing but the magnetic lines which are running from the north to the south pole. So it indicates the area until which the polarity of the magnets is available. Polarity means the north-south poles. Okay, so if I keep any other magnet nearby to this, means it also comes in the area of under the region of magnetic field of this magnet. So it gets attracted. This is what the magnetic field indicates. So similar way, whenever an electricity is passed, the magnetic field is noticed near to the circuit, and that is why the deflection in the magnetic compass is observed. Now let us understand the same concept. Here I have a circuit. I have a circuit connected to an iron nail. Okay. So this is a nail, and near at the end of the nail I have placed some ball pins. So what I have done is I have connected the nail to the wires of the circuit. Okay, on passing electricity, this object, iron nail, will also carry the current since the wires are wounded on it. I mean, it has been wounded in the sense rounded up on the nail. Can you see the wires rounded up on the nail and then again connecting it to the other end of the battery? So in this circuit, I have the switch battery, iron nail, and the wire wounded on the iron nail, and at the end of the iron nail I have placed the ball pins. So what I'm going to observe in this circuit example experiment is, on passing the electricity, the iron nail, which is also carrying the current carrying wire, which is carrying the current, will behave as a magnet and attracts the ball pins at the end. So yes, on passing the current, the iron nail will start to behave as a magnet since the wires carrying current are wounded on it, and it attracts the ball pins at the other end. It gets stuck to the iron nail. Okay, so this is the concept of electromagnetism. Okay, as the word tells, electro means on passing electricity, the magnetic effect is observed in an electric circuit. Since this object, that is our nail, acts like a magnet, I call it as an electromagnet. This principle is given the name as electromagnetism. Okay, this was found out by Hans Christian Oersted. So now, we human beings try to make the best out of whatever we invent, right? On finding out electricity, we saw how the heating effect was made into an utilizable one, and now this magnetic effect of electric current is also made as a beneficial one to the human beings, because it is finding its applications in the doctors, in toys, in electric bell, and in the ends of the crane. Okay, if you could see some dust on all, all the garbage and all would be dispersed by the help of the crane. Okay, the ends of the crane would have a bucket like shape like this. Okay, so that it carries the garbage on the hole. So this is a very heavy one. To lift this, we are using the electromagnets, since they are strong enough to magnets get strongly attached to each other, right? And the doctor is also using the electromagnets to remove some kind of small magnetic pieces if accidentally fallen in our eyes. And then the toys, you have the pencil boxes where you have the closing end. When you open like this, the other end will have the magnet, and on the top of the box also you will have the magnetic closing, automatic closing boxes, stationary boxes and all. And even in the toys and the electric bell. Okay, electric bell we have in our school, the normal automatic bells. But if you see a older version of the bells used in the schools, offices and all, they were all working on the principle of electromagnet. Okay, so you would have a gong at the end and a hammer will come and hit on the gong, and so that the sound is produced. So this is how a internal structure of an electric bell looks. Today I would teach you the working principle of an electric bell also, since we saw about what is electromagnet. And after watching this video, you just go and watch the next link which I have posted, that is the animated video explaining you how the electric bell operates. So in an electric bell, you would have this switch here. When you press the switch here, the hammer comes and hits on the gong. Okay, this is the visible one. No, when we have a look at the electric bell, if the hammer comes and hits on the gong and the ringing sound is produced. So inside the electric bell, what and all you have? You have the battery, you have the electromagnet, spring, iron strip, armature and the hammer and gong. Let me explain you each and everything. So electromagnet is nothing but a iron material, which is, since it is wounded with the electric wires, we call that as an electromagnet. It is going to behave as a magnet once the current flows. So the other end of this electric bell has another iron rod. The iron strip is called as your armature. Armature is, the meaning of armature is an object, the similar to an electromagnet. I can better say like that. Armature is also the meaning of electromagnet, an object which carries current. Okay, so this is an iron strip. Since it carries the current, I call it as armature. And the end of the iron strip, I have the hammer and a spring attached to here. So what happens is, when the current flows, this iron rod, since it is wounded with a coil, now it behaves like a electromagnet, attracts the iron strip. So it pulls, that is why I put the arrow mark towards this side. So this electromagnet pulls the iron strip towards its side. And what happens as it is pulled, the hammer comes and hits on the gong in the same direction. Understood? So we know that the electromagnet means they produce the properties of magnet. They try to attract each other. So the iron rod, since it is wounded with a wire, it behaves like an electromagnet and exhibits the magnetic properties. So what does it do? It pulls the iron strip, and when it is pulled, the hammer comes in, hits on the gong, and the ringing sound is produced. You would understand it better when you watch the animated video. If you have any doubt, call me. Thank you, children.